When Emma, a senior four student of Midland High School, wants to call his aunt, he comes to his phone booth. The order applies to the school's other students. Everything from school fees, scholastic materials, pocket money, even family issues is discussed here. The school forbids students from using mobile phones.
Mobile phones, we have a conviction that you need to hold a mobile phone if you are in position to control yourself. Most of these young learners have not yet learned. Some of them are very young. That if you gave him this gadget or her this gadget, he would spend the entire time on this gadget. Therefore, because of emotional instability, that's why people who have not yet matured, it will not be very good.
But Emma has a cell phone. His aunt bought for him.
It's simply because you need, most of the time you get bored, you need entertainment, you need to relax your mind, especially on weekends when you're free, when there's no stressive academic work.
Play some games.
Yeah, play some games. You need to Facebook, chat with friends. You know, now school gets boring when you have nothing to do.
In the last 10 years, access to phones and phone signal in the country has grown dramatically, and schools have come under pressure by students and some parents to allow learners to keep cell phones. The argument is that the kids need to stay in touch. But not everyone agrees. Maha says she's happy leaving her phone at home.
Would a phone distract you while at school?
Yeah.
How?
Like when you're at school, mm-hmm. your friends can be online. Like, let me say, not all of us that are in O-level, you have friends on FB that are in O-level. You may have campus friends. For them, they may be online and maybe they're in holidays. So you'll be busy chatting instead of reading books. Maybe that teacher has left you with notes to read. Or when you're having papers, you won't get time. You're like, let me chat with my friends. Mm-hmm. So maybe you miss them. Even sometimes some students disturb their parents, like, mommy, I don't have this. Every time you call.
So the young learners and mobile phones argument is as old as it is controversial. Those who oppose the idea say mobile phones break concentration, promote cyberbullying, and promote cheeky behavior. Those who support the idea say in this era of technology and e-learning, mobile phones are necessary evil.
In some schools outside Uganda, mobile phones have become part of the curriculum to supplement computer and IT lessons. Schools here, however, are still saying no.
It is a necessary evil, but as schools, we should, I think, look for the best alternative. For us here at Midland High School, our best alternative is the computer lab. We have internet 24/7.